The CMT Bowl and Tray Kit allows you to make beautiful divided bowls and trays like this and this. Let's get started by talking about the kit itself so that you can familiarize yourself with what's in the kit. Of course, we have to have patterns or templates. These patterns are what define the shape of bowl or tray that you're going to be able to make. Now, one thing that's really neat that you got to keep in mind is that many of the CMT templates are capable of making more than one shape. So with just a little bit of imagination, you'll be able to look at a template like this and really increase the vocabulary of shapes that you can create with just this one shape. So give that some thought. We'll talk more about that later. Additionally, in the kit, there is a bowl and tray router bit. The router bit is used, of course, to cut the wood out of the inside, excavate that material out so that you can hollow out the interior. Also included is a collet extension. The collet extension is required so that the bowls and trays can be deep, so that you don't have just a shallow bowl, but a bowl that's plenty deep to fill with fruit or nuts or cookies, whatever you choose to put in there. Now let's talk about the material requirements, what you need to glue up in order to make bowls and trays in your shop.
Carefully glue the material together, keeping it nice and flat. Use thick material in order to make deep bowls and trays. A maple cap was added to the mahogany base on this blank to provide contrast. Once the glue is dry, trace the pattern onto the bowl blank. Once the template shape is completely transferred to the bowl blank, you can head for the drill press. Use a Forstner bit mounted in the drill press to remove as much waste as possible from the interior of the bowl.
So now, most of the waste is taken out of there. Now we're done with the drill press. We're ready to route the rest of the waste out of this.
Add an extension base to your router so the base can completely span the recesses in the bowl and tray templates.
Now I want to stop here just so I can show you and make sure you understand how this whole system is working. On that first pass, the ball bearing traced the pattern. So there's just a little bit of a cut right here that the bit started to penetrate down into my bowl blank itself. So we've traced the pattern there. On my next pass, I'm going to lower the bit a little bit. The bearing is going to start to ride on the very top of my bowl. I'll just keep going down and down and down. Let's keep going with this one. We'll get this whole section excavated out. Now you can really see what's happening here. I've got all the waste out of there. That last pass, I swept back and forth across the bottom to get all the ridges out, the high and low spots left by the Forstner bit. So now I'll come and I'll do the middle. Of course, we only have to do that once. Then move the pattern to each quadrant and just keep taking the waste out. Take away everything that doesn't look like a bowl. Let's keep going. There we go. Got that last section done. We're all excavated out here. The next step is going to be to define the outside shape of this. I'll show you how to do that. On this one, I'm simply going to end up with a half inch wall around the outside So this is really very simple. Put the point of the compass, the pivot point, on the inside of the wall, and then just trace with the pencil on the outside.
Cut the outside shape by using a bandsaw.
Well, there we've got the rough outside shape of the bowl. Bandsaw marks all around there, a little bit irregular. So the next step, every woodworker's favorite, we got to do some sanding.
A stationary disc sander or belt sander provides one of the easiest ways to sand the outside of the bowl. Follow the disc sander with a random orbit sander, or if you don't own a disc or belt sander, go straight to the random orbit for sanding the exterior. Flexible discs like this, designed for sanding bowls on the lathe, work great on the bowl interior. Sand the bottom and sides of the bowl to remove any machining marks left behind by the router bit. Once most of the sanding is complete, ease the corners inside and out using a roundover bit in the router table.
Here at the bench, I'm working on the last of my finish sanding, making sure that everything is nice and smooth, feels great, looks great. This project is just about ready for finish. Let's look at some other projects here. This is the other template that comes with the kit, and it's used to make a big oval like this one. So with this template, you're going to use it like this, and then to get that angle in there, simply pivot the template. That's going to provide the other side. So this one's pretty far along. It's ready for this side to get routed, then sanding, cut the outside shape. Now remember earlier I was telling you how some of these patterns can be used in a variety of different ways. So for instance, let's have a look at what we've got here. Of course, in this case, I made four quadrants in this bowl by using the pattern four times. Another way to use this same pattern would be to only use it once. That gives me a little chip and dip cup, kind of a single serving size. So that's another way that you could use this. We could also take this same pattern and use it here and here with my two chip trays being 180 degrees apart. So don't just get married into the ideas that I've got here. There are a variety of ways you can use these templates. Make sure that you're really taking advantage of them, using them every way you can.